Good evening, my lovelies. Hope you're doing well. Love from Love, Life and Crafts. I hope that you have all had a lovely week. I apologize for my tardiness. As I mentioned in the previous video, I had a cold last week, so I couldn't do any videos. But today, I have two wonderful treats to show you. Let's get to it. This one is the Thornton's 10 Chocolate Fudge Brownie Bites. Yep. Let's open them up and try them. Ooh, they smell chocolatey. These come in a tray. Don't want to tip it too high because I don't want to spill them. Let's see. There we go. That's as far as I'm going to get without dropping them. Okay, alright. This is what they look like. It's a tiny little brownish square. They're quite moist actually. Let's try. Very, very moist. It's a bit like, you know when you have cookie dough and it's like uncooked dough, it's like that sort of consistency, but it's a chocolate brownie. Nice. These are the Thornton's brand, so they're a little bit more expensive compared to, say, Cadbury or the Superstore's own brand. I got these in the cooperative's shop. Which is, basically like a one-stop shop where you got your milk, your bread, and your essentials in there. But if you need anything more, then you'd have to go into town to get it, but it's a very known brand here, cooperative. They do a lot of charity work, which I think everybody's really appreciative of. And they sell a lot of goods, and they also do vegan, vegetarian stuff and fair trade things as well. So it's a very good store, and all the proceeds, like I said, go to charities, children in need, schools, guide dogs and other things as well, like cancer research. All the proceeds go into them. I think they also do work with food banks. Don't quote me on that. I'm pretty sure they do, but I'm not entirely accurate. So yeah, this is where I got it from. Again, it's the Thornton's Chocolate Brownie Bites. Very moorish. I'll put them away. And let's cleanse the palate. Again, I've got my traditional squash that we have in the UK. As mentioned in previous videos, it's a concentrated juice which you mix with water. I know in a lot of US stores they don't have squash, but they do have things like crusher or powdered lemonade and things like that, Gatorade and other bits and pieces. But squash is mainly native to the UK, and it's very convenient if you don't like plain water. It's also good for getting kids to drink their water, especially when they don't like plain water. And if it's a flavour that they like, they'll drink more of it. Yeah, and it just, it changes things up, really. And you got hundreds of different flavours. This one, I think, is either apple and blackcurrant or berries and cherries is generally what I get. I have ventured into apple and strawberry, which is quite nice. And summer fruits is quite nice as well. Lastly, I normally get Vimto, which is quite nice. You can get the still version or the fizzy version. You can get the no added sugar or the full fat of anything. I always get the no added sugar. It's a little bit healthier. And you can use more of it as well. That's why I get the double strength. Double strength means it's a stronger taste. And you use less, although I like quite a bit in mine. So, yeah, let's cleanse the palate. Let's have a chat for a minute. What are your plans for this weekend? I've been working in my craft shop. So I'll be able to do a shortly based on what I've made so far. I know that in America and some other countries overseas, Mothering Sunday is coming soon. So I've been working on that. Also Father's Day in June in the UK, I think overseas as well, I'm not sure. And Pride is for LGBT. And it is a day where we can all celebrate being who we are. I know that there is a lot of controversial stigma where people think that we shouldn't be allowed to have a day based on being LGBT and being able to celebrate it, but that's a topic for another day. I support LGBT myself, as I am also one of them. I have got that as one of my videos in my page. If you haven't watched it already, please go watch it. It's very informative, as well as my other vlogs and cooking videos, pet videos, craft videos. I do a little bit of everything really, so if you want to go watch them, please go watch them before you click like and subscribe. Please also share and comment. I want to know what you guys think. I want to continue making content that you guys like. And until you guys comment or like, the YouTube algorithm won't know if you're watching my content, which means it won't be sent out to everybody else, and you guys won't be able to watch as many videos, which is a shame really. But again, please don't do it because I say to, do it because you want to. I would love it if we could all love each other on this channel, not romantically but figuratively. I want you guys to feel comfortable in this channel and be able to talk about things that you want to talk about. Providing copyright on movies and things, I would have to work around that if you guys want me to do things like that. Also, I would have to put disclaimers because, again, I don't want to be kicked off of YouTube because of people not liking my content. So, please let me know what you want to watch, and also please don't like if you don't like the videos. If you do, let me know, you know, subscribe, message me. If you don't comment, I don't know you're watching the videos, so yeah, that's all I'm gonna say. Let's try the next yummy treat. This one is in the US as well, I think, but they have their own version, and it's also in Germany, but we have it in the UK as well. If you already guessed what I'm talking about, then clap for you. If not, I will show you now. There is many forms of this chocolate. but it's delicious either way. This is the Kinder Chocolate Bars. Traditionally, Kinder comes in a round egg, about this size, and it's got a little plastic egg inside, which you can pop open, and there's a toy with some stickers and other things in there, and you can build it or whatever. And, you know, some countries have it, some countries don't. I think the US might have their own version, but I don't think they have the toys in their country. But again, don't quote me. I'm only going by what I've heard, so I could have my information completely wrong. Anyway, again, Kinder chocolate bars. Let's crack one open. These come in various sizes. This one is the small bars. There's a small, medium, and I think there's a large bar as well. I've never tried the large one. I've only had the small or the medium. This is what they look like. Pretty small. I mean, I got small hands, and then that's the bar. You know, that's the bar. So it's pretty tiny. Generally, these are aimed at kids, but adults like them as well. Open them up. You get 10 in this pack, as it says on the box. You open it up like that. And that's what it looks like on the inside. And then it's got the individual squares. They pop open. And then it looks like that on the inside. You got the white chocolate. And then on the inside, you got the white chocolate. Very nice. These are pretty sweet, but they are quite moorish. Same as the brownies. It all depends what you like. These remind me of the Belgium chocolate spread that you can put on your toast. Ooh, there you go. So yeah, that's the two treats I've got to try today. Stay tuned for any more videos that come up. And have a good weekend. I'll see you guys soon. Love you. Bye.